What's up internet, Manish here and I'm back with another PLSQL tutorial and it is all about bind variables in PLSQL. So let's come straight to the tutorial. There are two types of variables in Oracle database. First, user variables, which we have discussed in PLSQL tutorial 2. If you haven't watched it, then find the link in the description. And second type of variables are bind variables, also known by the name of host variables. Unlike user variables, which can only be declared inside the declaration section of PLSQL block, you can declare a bind variable anywhere in the host environment. And that is the reason why we also refer bind variables as host variables. According to Oracle docs, bind variables in Oracle database can be defined as the variables that we create in SQL Plus and then reference in PLSQL. So let's move ahead and see how to create or say declare a bind variable. We can declare a bind variable using variable command. Variable command declares the bind variable which you can refer in PLSQL. Also, as I mentioned earlier in this tutorial that in order to declare bind variable, we do not need to write any PLSQL block or section. Let's do an example and declare our first bind variable. See how easy it is to declare a bind variable in Oracle database? You simply have to write a command which starts with keyword variable, followed by the name of your bind variable, which is completely user defined, along with the data type and data width. That's how we declare a bind variable in Oracle database. Did you notice that I didn't write any PLSQL block or section here to declare this bind variable, which is very unlike the user variable. Declaring the bind variable is the first use of this variable command. There are few other uses also, which I have explained in detail in my blog, so I highly recommend you to read that article. You can find the link in the description box. As we have now declared the bind variable, next we have to initialize it. We have several different ways of initializing the bind variable. Let's see what those are. First, you can initialize the bind variable using execute command. Let's see how it works. Let's initialize our bind variable v_bind1 with a string rebellion rider. This statement starts with the keyword exec, which is the starting four alphabets of keyword execute. You can either write the whole keyword execute or just the starting four alphabets, which is exec. Both will work the same. Followed by the name of our bind variable, which is v_bind1. After the name of bind variable, we have assignment operator, followed by the string rebellion rider. As it's a string, thus it's enclosed in single quotes. That's the first way of initializing the bind variable. Another way of initializing is by explicitly writing execution section of PLSQL block. Let's check this out also. This is a simple execution block where I initialize the bind variable v_bind1 with the string Manish Sharma. Let's execute, but first we will execute this first statement and declare our bind variable. Okay, done. Now let's execute this execution block, check this box and hit apply. As you can see, PLSQL procedure successfully completed. That is how we initialize the bind variable in Oracle database or in PLSQL. Now you asked, Manish, why did you put that colon sign before the name of bind variable v_bind1 while initializing it? Glad you asked. Unlike user variables, which you can access simply by writing their name in your code, you use colon before the name of a bind variable to access them. Or in other words, you can reference bind variable in PLSQL by using a colon followed immediately by the name of the variable as I did here. Till so far, we have learned how to declare, reference and initialize a bind variable. Next, we will see how to display the value stored in this variable. There are three ways of displaying the value held by bind variable in PLSQL or say in Oracle database. Let's check them out one by one. First, using dbms_output package. This is the simplest way to display the value held by any variable in PLSQL. So let's check out how we can use this statement to display the current value of our bind variable v_bind1. Let's use this same execution block and add our dbms_output statement. Things that you must keep in mind here are dbms_output.putline is an executable statement which will require the execution section of PLSQL block for its execution. In simple words, you can only execute this statement in execution section of PLSQL block, otherwise you will get an error. Also, to see the output return from this DBMS underscore output statement, you have to set the server output on. And you can do that by simply writing and executing set server output on. I have explained PL SQL blocks and section in my PL SQL tutorial 1. I suggest you to take a look at that video also. The second way of displaying the current value of a bind variable is by using print command. Like DBMS underscore output statement, print command also displays the current value of the bind variable, except that you can write this command in host environment rather than inside any PL SQL block or section. Yes, similar to variable command, print command does not require any PL SQL block for execution. Suppose you want to see the current value of bind variable v underscore bind1, for that simply write the print command in your SQL plus. Let's do it. Let's execute. As you can see, here is the result. If you will write print command without any argument, then this will display you the current value of all the bind variables with their names in the session. There is one more way in which you can display the current value stored in any bind variable, and that is by setting the auto print parameter on. For that, you simply have to write and execute this command. That's all you have to do, and this point onward Oracle server will print the value of your bind variable automatically without the use of any specific command or statements such as print or DBMS underscore output which we just saw. Let's do an example. Let's first close this output window and clear out the screen. As you can see, I simply wrote three separate statements, where in the first statement I am setting auto print parameter on, in second statement I have declared a bind variable, and in the third statement I initialize the bind variable. There is no statement which will display the value of the bind variable which we have here. But if auto print parameter is set to on, then Oracle server will print the value of the bind variable at the execution of the statement which is initializing it. This means that when I will execute the third statement, the value of this bind variable will be displayed automatically. So let's move ahead and execute each of these statements one by one. Statement 1 executed, auto print parameter is on now. Statement 2 executed, bind variable is declared now. Let's execute the third statement and see what happens. Statement 3 executed, and as you can see, Oracle has displayed the value stored in the variable. These are the three different ways of displaying the current value of any bind variable in Oracle PL SQL. This topic of bind variable is really very important from the development, certification exam and interview perspective. Thus, I have done a detailed blog on the same, which I highly recommend you to read. You can find the link in the description box. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, then please hit the thumbs up button. You can also share this tutorial on your social, and don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you soon. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.